Hello my dear friends, welcome back again in the new video of Power Learning channel. So in today's video we will see about three-phase AC alternator, what are the major components and how these alternators are producing electricity. So in front of you it's a complete view of three-phase AC alternator with all the major parts and the wiring connection, how they are producing alternator. So this is the one example of self-excitation system. I will explain you the major parts in this video. If you are new on this channel, hit the subscribe now to watch more informative videos in coming future. So as you see my dear friends, in three-phase alternators what we have major things. First of all, we have stator winding and we have rotor winding. So what is our stator windings? If you see this gray color, this is stationary part and it is called stator winding. These red wires are showing that these are stator winding, which is located inside the housing of stator. This part, it's called stator, while this inner part which is having a shaft, this one side of the shaft will connected with the engine and the other side of the shaft will be connected with the bearing. So it will balance the rotor inside the stator winding. And as you see on the rotor, we have four windings, 1, 2, 3, 4. These four windings are series winding and connected with each other. It is making four poles electromagnet. Two poles are north and two poles are south. So these are the major two windings of our three-phase alternator. Other than this, we have also here some more windings which is called excitation system. So now we are talking about self-excitation system. So you will see here we have two more windings here. One is field winding and one is armature winding. Field winding, this is called exciter winding also, or exciter stator, because stator is stationary and the armature is revolving. What we have, our field winding will get excited with the DC, and once the armature revolves around, it will produce three-phase AC. This three-phase AC power, we take it from armature and giving to our rotating diodes, because these two parts, armature and diodes, are installed on the main shaft of the rotor. So they are always revolving with the engine, while our exciter field winding, they are stationary, they are not revolving. So how the system are work and what are the remaining major parts? Here you see we have also AVR, which is called automatic voltage regulator. So we have many types of AVRs. So this is showing the basic type of the AVR, which is having only four wires. I will explain you in this video. So now we will start. Before starting, as you see here, we have three things which is showing red. If you see anything red, it will shows that it is carrying, these wires are carrying alternative current. Green means it is carrying direct current, and blue means voltage sensing wires. So here you see we have three phase stator winding, which is showing red phase, are connected on the terminal. These are the three phases which we see in normally in the alternator, red, yellow, blue. These are the three phases. From two phases we took the voltage sensing with the blue color of the wires and connected on our AVR. So it's mean AVR is getting AC supply from the main alternator. And what is the function of AVR? To regulate and to convert this AC voltage into DC and gives to our main field winding stator. Once this field winding get excited with the DC power, okay, it will produce electromagnet inside, because there is many windings inside. The series windings are connected with these two wires. And once the armature revolves inside this stationary exciter, it will produce three phases on the armature winding. And this three phase, we took it from armature and connected on our diodes. And these diodes will convert this AC supply into DC. And this DC is going to our main rotor. So once it is reached to main rotor, so it will make a revolving electromagnet. Once the revolving electromagnet moves inside the stationary winding of a stator, the electricity will be produced as per Faraday's law of electromagnet induction. So this is the total, the complete process of how the voltage is produced. But here many people, they comment us and they asking us how this voltage sensing we will get in the beginning while the generator is in stop condition. So there is one thing which is called residual magnetism, which is stored in the main stator winding. So once we start the engine, it will gives a small amount of voltage to the AVR, and AVR convert this minimum voltage and gives to field winding, and then armature will convert this small voltage AC into DC and it will give to rotor. With this cycle, the voltage process build up, the voltage will build up, and slowly slowly while the engine speed is increasing, the voltage will build up to the nominal values required. Once the nominal value is received, the AVR will start controlling the desired voltage level. So this is the whole process of how the alternators are producing three phases in AC alternators. So I hope if you have still any confusion, you can comment below. Inshallah, I will try to give you the answer. And we'll see you in the next video. If you like my video, please hit the like button and subscribe my channel and share this video with your friends. Thank you very much.